I chose my grandfather, Albert Hariri. I think he's a mitzvah hero because of all the wonderful things he does for the community and his family. Albert was born on November 28, 1937. He just celebrated his 77th birthday. He was born in Brooklyn in New York City and was named after his mother's father, Abraham. His mother was named Fortuna and his father was David. He has two older sisters, Grace and Celine. They both still live in Brooklyn. Grace has two children, Alice and Meyer. Alice has two daughters, Alexis and Amanda. Al had five uncles and an aunt. They all married and had children who are now his first cousins. The Brooklyn neighborhood he lived in was called Bensonhurst, where he met his friend Gerald Turner, who lived a block from him at PS 247. He went through all the schools through high school with Joel. Joel still lives in New York City. They still see each other regularly. Life in Brooklyn in the 1940s was really nice for Albert. There were lots of nice stores and restaurants nearby. There were many children his age. Albert and everyone living near him were all fans of the Brooklyn Dodgers baseball team. All of Brooklyn was heartbroken when they left in 1957 and became the Los Angeles Dodgers. Albert had a great bar mitzvah. All of his family was there, mother, father, grandmother, sister, uncles, and his friends. He had an open house celebration at his house and all day and night. There were great Sephardic pastries and other foods cooked by his mother and family friends. People visited all day and night long. He got so many presents, he piled them up in a room. He still has one of the presents, a pearl-covered prayer book from his mother. While growing up, his favorite Jewish holiday was Passover. On Passover, he had seders at his house. His mother, Fortuna, would cook with help from his sister, Nina. Albert said it was like a banquet. His father, David, would lead the seder. His uncles, Maurice and Clement, plus his brother-in-law, Felix, would be participating knowledgeably. He and his sister's mother and grandfather, Serena, were there too as participants. He worked in New York City from 1960 to 1971. In 1971, Albert was working in Manhattan when he received word that a Connecticut electric utility named United Illuminating, headquartered in New Haven, in his becoming director of all computers for the companies. But Al had lived in Brooklyn all of his life. He was married and had a daughter, my mom, who were all very settled in New York. He took the New York Central train in Grand Central Station to Manhattan to New Haven, about a two-hour ride. He had a good interview. The job area looked very good, and after long discussions with the family, especially about leaving their friends and families 2 hours away, he took the job. Then he had to find a place to live. After many trips and